Hi, I'm going to show you how to do the no knot system of chair caning. Instead of tying knots at the end of a strand like this one, which is the normal procedure, what I do is to take that little tail, I call it a tail, and put it up underneath the chair in the hole next to it. In this instance, it's to the left, and my weaver strand is also going to the left. So when I get the end of that, I put it up next to the little tail into the hole on the left and pull it up, and then I pull this up tight. This is the little tail being pulled up tight against the bottom of the chair. Then I pull the weaver strand up also and pull those both up so they're nice and snug. Then on the top side of the chair, I take my scissors. I don't know if I can do this with doing the camera work also, but I take my scissors and cut off the strand, the little tail, at the top level with the chair seat, and that just cuts it off. You need to make sure that you're not cutting off the wrong strand, and that's happened to me before too. Okay, so then you just pull it up snug and continue on your weaving pattern, and every time you go through that hole again, it's going to reinforce, it's going to strengthen that tail, and it's going to be nice and tight up against the bottom of the chair, and you won't have any knots. Now we'll go underneath and take a look at it again, and you'll see how nice and neat that is. And then you want to do that every time you come to a tail rather than tying off a knot. And then the final completion step is to go around the outside perimeter through all these holes with a binder cord. It's a wider binding cane that's usually about 4 millimeters. Sometimes it's 5 millimeters, and you weave that on. You lay it down and then you weave it on, similar to what they do with a bobbin on a sewing machine, and that gives it a nice finished look. Thanks. Bye. Here's our final shot of the underneath side of that hold-a-hole cane chair using the no-knot method of tying off. There are no knots to speak of at all on the underneath side of this chair. And it's a very nice, neat presentation as far as I'm concerned. I think it looks wonderful. And this is something that I learned by studying some antique chairs from the 1800s when I first started doing chair caning over 35 years ago. And I've used this method ever since I discovered it. I just think it's wonderful. So professional looking and nice and neat. And I hope you'll all try to do this no-knot method of chair caning also. Thanks. Happy weaving. From the Wicker Woman, Catherine Peters.